Is coffee considered an essential? Like, what? How did coffee become essential? Yes, people. It's a like in one way, it's a drug because people like to have it and consume it. But is it an actual essential? Like milk, eggs, dairy. That's like, those are probably what people consider essentials. Is coffee?
But I think that how. I'm asking, what is up, Ori? As you know, it's a special episode. It is the Christmas special. Dun, dun, dun.
Woo!
And we have something special. And as you know, we're in our resident place, as you know, our BFFs, Hummussiah. We also have the, if you can, because I'm terrible at pronunciation.
So we have some delicious food today, sponsored by Grazed Platters.
Grazed?
Just grazed, like a grazed platter.
Can you just spell it for me? So I'm like,
so it's on Instagram. We're going to throw up the link above the, sorry, the icon above,
but
it's
for the
G-R-A-Z.
Okay. G-R-A-Z. Right?
Dot E-D.
E-D.
Platters. So platters. Grazed platters. Okay. Like you're grazing over food.
Right. Okay. I see what you're saying.
So we're like gonna throughout this episode, we're going to go have some amazing snacks, amazing eats actually.
Right.
Savory, sweet. We got it all.
To start off the whole thing, you know, the holiday season, it's getting difficult. A lot of businesses, you know, we're coming out of lockdown, and you know, a lot of businesses have, you know, lost, have gone bankrupt. There's articles out there that we've seen from like Blogtio that says 140 have closed. I've seen like other ones that saying hundreds of stores.
Since the start of the pandemic.
Yeah, exactly. And there's been so many issues, like people can't even like, they can't even afford, like, the problem is even the government's like, oh, we can, you know, cover 75% of your cost. But if you're a clothing company, right? If you're like a small clothing company, right? You've seen a lot of them on Avenue Road, right? Mm-hmm. North of Lawrence or whatever. There's like, I was walking by with my mother the other day and all of them are like Boxing Day special, this and that. Like, but like, are they allowed to open? Are they like, what is the process, right? Like right now, everyone's so limited in the sense to like, can you even go into these stores, right?
It's sad because if you haven't adapted to the new climate of, you know, online e-commerce,
right,
and you have stores or websites that are able to, because like, it's funny because there are still people going to their stores, but no one's going into the stores. So if you own a, say, for example, a nail salon, you can't, what, you can sell nail polish? Great. But it's not enough to maybe go into work even. It's not worth it to even open up your doors because you're still,
how many nail polishes do you have to sell before you,
exactly,
like, you know, like most, I think most females spend between like, let's say $35 to like $100 to do nails, pedicure, manicure,
yeah,
and maybe like waxing or eyebrows, yeah, or whatever it may be, right? A mix of all. So,
and
it's
then hard.
And like, if you're like, now you're selling a service, right? A person's, mm-hmm, physically doing that for you versus now nail polish costs them $5 and they're selling for $10. So they're only making $5 before it's like $100.
And wait, how about that hydro? How about the heating? How about everything that's there? You still got to pay for that stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
And yes, the government is coming in and implementing new rules, but still, businesses are going to fall apart if there's no, if it's not immediate. Like, and that's an issue that people are having. And as many of you know, Adam Skelly, Adam's Barbecue, that's a whole topic by itself.
Yeah, like there's so many things.
He kind of stirred the pot.
Yeah, exactly. And there's a lot of businesses that were, I saw from everything from like some gym started opening up, yeah, in Mississauga or some, I can't remember the location.
And the police came in.
Right? Yeah. And they're like, and they gave them a ticket. And I'm like, And the guy's like, well, I only have 10 people inside. Everyone's wearing masks. We're following policy. But it's just like, it's super difficult to, you know, like, I understand it's very difficult for these businesses, right? If you're not in the food business right now, right? Or in the non-mandatory.
Like if you're not as considered an essential service.
You. If you're not considered an essential, and a lot of company, like a lot of people are misunderstanding what essential, because that gym, I was listening to the owner and he says, it's very vague essential. How do I know? Maybe I am essential. People need to go to the gym. People need to get healthy.
I've spoken to a bunch of people about this. Like say you're in nail salon, but wait, what if you get a liquor license to sell alcohol? Have you become now essential business? Because technically you are, because alcohol is an essential business, is an essential service. So
right.
What is there kind of like a gray area? Like it's kind of, people I'm sure are toying with the lines.
And
who's really gonna come in and be like, oh, you can't really sell that. Like everyone's trying to survive.
I remember you were saying something about a coffee store switched to start getting alcohol,
yeah, like
right?
A bodega.
A bodega, yeah, in a sense. So like you get that experience of, you know, getting, you know, a and I remember in previous episodes, we were talking about like coffee and like they were starting selling like hip clothing, right? You said like the thing. So now are you, oh no, I guess clothing is not considered, but a coffee is, right? Because it's the, like Starbucks
but
are
is,
all open.
But is coffee considered an essential? Like what, how did coffee become essential? Yes, people, it's a like in one way it's a drug because people like to have it and consume it, but is it an actual essential? Like milk, eggs, dairy. That's those are probably what people consider essentials. Is coffee?
But I think that how
I'm asking. I'm more of a question.
I totally see that. Like I'm just saying from my personal point of view. Like alcohol, right? A lot of people are dependent on alcohol, right? And same thing with coffee. People need their morning. Like I know some people who drink minimum 1 to 5 coffees a day throughout the day.
I believe
some of them have machines at home, right? And cool, good for them. And some people don't like the taste. Like I have a friend of mine, he went out because he's like, oh, it's really expensive, especially with COVID. He went to Costco and he purchased one of the Keurig machines, right? For whatever, $100 or say, or $50, whatever it is. He bought the pods, tried it at home. And he says, I hate it. Tastes disgusting.
Yeah.
But I go to Starbucks, I get my 2 espresso shots with this, cost $4. And I like it. I enjoy it. I enjoy the warmth. It's nice, the smell, and you know, that experience altogether. And I think like,
I respect that. I respect, sorry to cut you off.
No, you're not at all.
I respect that. I respect people going out and, you know, spending money on coffee and stuff like that. But like, it's kind of the back of my head. Gary Vee's in my head all the time. It's like, it's sad because I can make a coffee and I can make a darn good coffee. It's not professional, like barista style, but I can, you know, I have the special beans, I grind my own beans. I have a Starbucks that costs $2.50, the Starbucks machine. I'm not a professional.
Wait, oh, $250
cost? Yeah, because I got it a long time ago. It was a special Starbucks. We got it for a deal.
Oh, okay.
And so the one that we have, I can show you the one I have. I literally will show you on a photo above because it's really cool in the sense that I just like grab my own beans. I can go buy my different beans from different places. Colombian.
Do you have Ecuador. A steamer as well on it?
I do have a steamer on it.
Okay. I've looked into those, like those steamers with all that. And all together, those cost like $1,000.
It ranges. It really ranges because if you're buying Breville, which is a brand name, or you're buying like these, like you can go to Fema, which is a
but I'm not even talking about the expensive ones because my friend bought one recently. It was $2,000, and I know another person who bought one for $5,000. But it makes espressos. It makes this. It's like
I'm not looking for the whole coffee shop experience. I'm just looking for like I can make a coffee. I add my milk into it. I actually don't steam my milk. I just put it into the microwave. It saved me so much time and effort.
Wait, what?
I put my milk in the microwave.
You put your milk in the microwave?
Because I want to make it warm. I want to make everything warm. It's not wrong.
Really?
It's like, what, 30 seconds in the microwave? Because I'm too lazy to steam it.
So
I know reliability of a microwave. Steaming is
easy and quick and easy.
But I just, I'm a habit. I'm a person of habit. So like, I can put it into the microwave, which is fine.
So I've tried it, but I kind of make a mess sometimes. I put heavy
cream. I put a lid on top of it.
And I put a lid and it sometimes explodes off.
Well, I don't put it for like, pardon me. I don't put it in for a minute. And that's why.
But yeah, I think there's so many different like experiences, right? Like I got my Keurig machine, right? And I bought it from eBay and I got it on special for like $40. It was originally a $100 machine. I got a super on discount because it was a refurbished one, but I was like, I don't care. It's fully cleaned and whatever. Yeah. And it works. I've been using for the past since the pandemic. And now instead of getting 3 or 4 coffees a week out, I get like now maybe 1 a week. And then the rest I drink every morning, right? At home.
That's the thing. Like I respect, like I was talking about Gary Vee. If you can afford a $4, $5 coffee, by all means, go pay for 100%. It. I spend $5 on a coffee at Starbucks.
Like you easily. Just had a coffee today. How much was that? The one that you just paid
two,
for?
I got two, one for me and one for the cameraman. Thank you. Because he's the man. Cameraman.
How much was it?
$2. It was $8 for
why did you buy a coffee? Why couldn't you wait till getting home or drinking your
because I want Coke. You know, we're recording, we're having a good time.
But I'm trying to say like at the same time
when you're out, like the Starbucks app is fantastic. And so I don't typically go get a second coffee if I'm not at home. Like if I'm already home, I'm gonna have a second one at home because I can save. I buy the 2 pounds of whatever, 1 pound of coffee beans for $25, whatever the price is.
Right.
And so I just grind them up. It saved a lot of money.
Of course. I 100% agree with you. And I think there's a lot of ways that people are adapting today with being stuck at home and businesses like not being open or considered essential, whatever. And like, you know, and I think from that on, it's again, to go back, I think we should support so local. That's a very important thing. Always. Because a lot of these companies are barely surviving. Mm-hmm. Right. And it's a very important time because another, One last thing I wanted to bring up is I read a stat that most companies make most of their profit within the holiday season.
Yeah, the Black Friday. That's why is it called Black Friday?
It's blackout. You kind of like empty out, like empty warehouses.
It's from when, if I believe correctly, is when you go from the red, when you're in the negative, to the positive, to the black. That's where you make your money. And it's hard because you have a behemoth.
I said the green. It should have been
to the green. The green.
Green Friday.
And it's when you have behemoths like Amazon and, you know, Alibaba, and I respect them for sure.
Right.
And they're taking up everyone else and they're eating them up. And the small businesses that we try to support, like today, who we're giving, you know, thank you so much for the food sponsors.
Right.
Sponsor.
So since you're bringing that up, give a little back.
We got this amazing charcuterie board courtesy of Graz Platters. And it sells for $100.
Right.
And it comes with different portions. It has, you know, sweet, savory, you know, everything on it. This time we're going into the savory stuff, which is your meats, your cheese, your crackers. It's going to be fantastic. We're really excited to try it.
And yeah, it's when you take a look at it, like we've seen it, it's a mammoth of a beast. You're on YouTube, of course. Like, make sure to check out YouTube and subscribe. That's a great place if you're on the audio only at this point. Like, just go check it out, or check it out on the Edible Talk. We'll have some photos there as well. But it's such a mammoth. Like, for $100, like, honestly, right now, I remember getting one of those gift baskets, and the gift baskets, perfect. I got nothing in it. Like, perfect. I got three chocolate bars in it, a teddy bear maybe, and like,
exactly,
like a coffee bean.
I was gonna throw that in there. I was gonna say, you know, this is the perfect gift for giving, you know,
especially for you know, Christmas, or especially for New Year's or things like that, or any holidays. Yeah,
hey,
any.
If you like somebody, you spend $100, it goes a long way. You're supporting a beautiful person, amazing person who makes amazing food, and I respect.
Oh, we forgot to say it's halal as well.
It's halal. All the meats are halal. We forgot to mention.
Right.
Everything. She's based out of Vaughan.
Okay.
She'll do contactless delivery and yeah, all throughout the GTA pickup as well. It's cheaper if you pick it up, I believe, and
but at least she gives a delivery option. That's awesome.
Which is amazing.
So what, should we just dig
in? Let's do it.
We're going to the meat first. We're going to make a little baby sandwich here. Like, as you said, like, it was funny. We can make your own cracker, right? So make your own.
Yeah.
So you have a cracker. They have two different cheeses.
The brie cheese.
They have the brie cheese, and they have the, I wish I knew the other cheese. I'm not well versed. But yeah, I think right here it says cheeses, but there's two types, like brie and like.
It's like a cheddar, I want to say.
So I don't know how. It's like not a cheddar. I think maybe it has, because there's like peppercorn in it. Oh, it might be peppercorn thing. So I'm just going to try different things individually with the cracker.
Just rip it. At this point, rip it. How is it?
I like the peppercorn one. Ooh, has a lot of flavor. You know what's crazy? I also didn't think about this. And I might be wrong, but it's halal, right?
Ooh, it's so that means too.
Yeah, it has a kick to it. What was I gonna say? It's halal, so that means the cheese is halal too. That means there's no
everything.
There's no maybe no like pork products in it, like in the cheese as well. So like she might go out of her way for that, because you know a lot of cheeses these days have like pork fat, beef fat, chicken fat, all that kind of stuff in it. I'm gonna try the other one, the brie now, right? This is the brie. That's what it's called,
right? Meat as well.
Well, I haven't tried with meat. I gotta taste that.
Some spice here. It's nice.
Yeah, beef.
It's good.
Sorry, I'm hesitant. Whenever I see red meat, like, I guess like...
Oh, no, it's pork.
No. No, it's beef.
Are you sure?
200%.
I think it tastes like pork. Well, I'm winking. To our viewers on YouTube, I'm winking. To our viewers in the car, I'm winking.
It's spicy. I like it. I like this. It has red... It has red chili flakes in it, in the meat. I know this very well because I always add it into like different soups and stuff, and it's so good. And then I have like other fig.
I can't get over. We were having like maybe two or three crackers. I'm like, I feel like there's so much. There's so much.
This is just a tip of the iceberg.
Yeah, exactly. We're just like the appetizers right now.
Really good.
There's a fig we got here.
Do you bite into it? Do you bite the skin? Yeah, that's why. You can eat the skin or eat it like a I can spoon it out, the pineapple present. It's really good.
Fresh.
Very fresh, and it has like, it's very juicy too. Like, I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's super juicy inside.
Do you know why I like charcuterie boards?
Why?
It just has everything. It's like a smorgasbord of food. Mm-hmm. So if you're feeling peckish for like sweets, you can go sweet. You can go like savory.
She can customize these, right? Yeah, like this, you can this, tell this her like, I want 50% dessert, 50% cheese, and no meat.
I can be like, I want to spend $75. I want just cheese or just meat, whatever the price is.
Or you can customize. Like, oh, I don't know.
There's different prices. There's different prices. Okay. So you can spend $55, $100, $250, whatever it is. You can make a whole table of it if you want.
Just to clarify, $100 is this big. So that, like, easily this can serve what, 8-10 easily, like 8 people, like everyone, like having a small plate, easily 8-10
I've
people.
Worked with other charcuterie companies in the past, and it just depends. It just depends on what you
I think it's how big your corporation is, exactly. As well, because she's an independent local business, so she's able to, she doesn't have to pay that much for advertising that. Yeah. It's more local in her.
It's like word of mouth in a lot of her businesses. Like, of course she's using us as one way to promote herself, which mm-hmm. which is a great way. It's an honor, actually, to be able to, on My Foodie on the Loose, mm-hmm. on DJ Dave K, we're going to promote it, and also on our Edible Talk, which is like, it's a win all around in a sense.
Of course. It's, you know, we love exposure. As we said, like, we always try to support locals. We're supporting local here at the Hummussiah, right? Yeah. Our to-go place to eat, like, to record.
Some guys like walk past because we're still like live.
Yeah, recording. Because it's live. Like, people are walking by in the hallway. We're isolated in our own space. Mm-hmm. But yeah. I think that's it kind of ties into like what you were saying, like, you know, it's such a good thing to like bring a dish, someone's you love, like, and the big thing during this holiday season is like family and you know, your cultures and religion, like, you know, how many holidays are right now, right? Hanukkah
got it all.
Is, you know, happening, right? We got Christmas coming up, we have New Year's coming out, oh yikes, we have, you know,
Kwanzaa, we got all these
Kwanzaa, I don't know,
Diwali,
Diwali just passed, I heard. So, like, you know, I you know, there's so many holidays and there's so many different, right? Like, as you know, Merry Christmas, you filthy animal. It's like, you know, everyone's funny. used to the, you know, the
holiday spirit, the vibes of the holiday season.
And exactly. Now
I feel like we've transitioned into a totally different time and a different, you know, this whole lockdown and darker weather, and like it's
yeah, like, it goes dark, it's at like 4:30, yeah, exactly, or something.
I think it's so depressing, it's so sad, and there's less light, it's colder, it's just it's not your typical time where, you know, pre-COVID, where you can go to Miami or what, people that have a luxury of traveling and luxury of doing things, but also spending time with your loved ones is much more limited nowadays, because you have to like stay at home and like live like in, like, basically feel like we're in an igloo, you know, like stuck
exactly
at home. It's like, oh, I hate that.
You're like, man, I wish we had so much like flexibility, right? Like to go out and do stuff, like being in the red zone or wherever we are, right? It's
it affects everything in life. Like, you want to go, oh, I can't actually go.
So here's a good example. One thing that I know you wanted to look at it too. You remember the at Yorkdale, they have the Avengers thing, this really cool thing.
Yeah.
Like And like you kind of walk through a place. And so I spoke to them when I went to York. Yeah. They're like, so they do every superhero, all the main characters, and each of their main characters. So one, they're going to be like, here's Iron Man, and they give like an Iron Man's area, then the Thor, then Captain. That's each, so there's cool. Different areas. And then when I spoke to them, they originally in November, like, what was it, 20, whatever it was, they said, oh, we're not opening until January 1st now because of the lockdown. I'm like, what? No, but like, I wanted to see it during the holidays.
And you know, Yorkdale's not a cheap place to have rent. They're probably going, darn, like, you know, I can't even... I'm paying X amount of money.
Now they're like, well, we wish we did it outdoors somehow, you know?
Yeah,
you can't even do that.
Just like that. It's such a fluid situation that people, it's always changing. And people,
exactly.
You sign a lease or you sign a contract, and next thing you know, it's, oh, by the way, we can't actually do this. Good luck. And you've dished out except like thousands of dollars.
Right. And that's a problem. Like, now we have, like, as we were saying, there's limitation on how many people can be indoors, right? How many people you can go to, like, public events, like, not public events, like if you're having a wedding, right? A wedding that was pretty thing. It's like 10, right? People.
Nothing.
So imagine, like, the groom, the priest, and the bride, that's already 3 people. Your best man, your best woman, that's already 5 people. So mom, dad, yeah. And then one person, grandma. Like, that's it. That's 10 people. Oh, no. How about people who are serving food? Are they even,
is food allowed in?
I know.
Contactless food, we throw it at you. We throw the food in here.
Open your mouth. Wait, paramedic, we need one person to leave so the paramedic can come in. Okay.
it's we're laughing, but it's so sad. Reality is so sad that we have.
Let's put it this way. You have to make the best out of it and like use humor. I think humor is very important to like diffuse situations because totally. If you like, I'm not like, don't take like, I wouldn't say like use this as a like, you know, anything like death and world related. Like you want to make sure to try to make the most positive.
Make light of the situation.
Yeah, exactly. Because instead of like, if you're like, oh, everything's going to get worse, everything's going to like, think of positive thoughts. I think that's really important. Like during the, especially the holiday season, like, If you know someone, make sure to Zoom call them, right? Your grandmother, your mom, if you're in different places, like call them, right? I think that's
if you're in downtown, there's lots of spots you can go to. Like the Distillery District they do a fantastic job this time of year because they have the big Christmas tree, they have the lights,
and they have lighting,
the heart structure. But if you're in Yorkville, I just went there the other day, they have beautiful, you know, lights, and they make it basically like a light show kind of in a way. I think it's like, if you're already being outside, the only thing you can do is walk to this, in the area with lights.
Especially when you're like near the CN Tower, right? With the aquarium and all that. Just like kind of walking by, looking at the CN Tower, the bright, you know, lights. I love it. That's one of my favorite things. Like, especially walking through the city lights.
I like that drive when you're going from west to east and on the Gardener and you're going into the city.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That's like my
favorite. With the blue sunset. Light against the Rogers Center. You get the lights.
It's such a nice time.
I didn't talk about that. Did you hear about the demolition of the Rogers Center?
No.
Yeah, they're destroying the stadium. So I found
Wait, what?
Right. So I'm gonna talk about this a little bit.
You're kidding. This is like an April Fool's kind of joke?
No, 200%. So don't quote me on the number, but 2050, the land is rented by the government or by the natives, but I think it's rented to the Rogers Stadium to have a stadium. It's only permitted to have a stadium on it. But because our stadium was built so long ago, it doesn't have all the new cool stuff that other stadiums have. So what they were supposed to do is destroy the stadium and rebuild a new stadium. But what they said, because of COVID, they're delaying there. But of course, like, imagine how many billions of dollars they lost not having two seasons now, or one and a half seasons, right?
Blue Jays.
Blue Jays.
The Argos used to be there.
Now they're at the BMO. But there's also concert. Like, I was supposed to go to Justin Bieber, remember? Front row seat, man. Like, not front. It was a fifth row from the front.
Which is basically front row. He's you know, when you're 5 row, you can see his spit coming.
Like, if you're here, you can see his spit coming. It would be like, you know, not too far away. Like, yeah. I was so sad that I didn't get that experience.
If you ever need tickets, he's the guy for any tickets.
I mean, anything. I'm gonna call them out, like the company. But SeatGeek, I'm telling you right now, if you're looking to buy tickets, this is not a, sorry, let me rephrase. This is not a sponsored ad, but SeatGeek, I love you. They have, like, sometimes they have tickets that cost originally $100. Somehow they have it at $50. It's $50 US, but when you do the conversion, it's like $70, and you're like, $70 is still an amazing deal for $100 ticket that would have cost. So somehow, like, either, like, sometimes people are selling it last minute because they can't attend the event. So like, oh, it's better for me to get 70 than zero, right? And my number one thing, what I usually do is buy them last minute. When you buy them last minute, you get the best deals.
That's a good take home.
But yeah, I think we should move forward. We got more of the, I can't pronounce it. I say
charcuterie
board. So, yeah,
nice.
And that was that nice?
It was very good.
I say charcuterie.
Sound like a radio host. Charcuterie.
Charcuterie board. Today we'll be having this.
We are about to try three different dips. These dips, which is the first one, is the fig jam.
Mm-hmm.
Looks delicious. We got the tzatziki. And we have this kind of medley of olive, peppers, tomatoes with a relish with a touch of spice. So
awesome.
I feel like they're going to be very different because they are different. Oh, they're
super different.
The colors even are by itself.
Do you want to go with the figs on the cracker first?
Well, let's try that. I was feeling that for sure.
I was kind of also like thinking, should we try one of these apricots that they have and like dip it? Let's try that.
I'll go with the raspberry. It's right.
With the strawberry. So yeah, I'll go with this. You go with that before we bite it. Oh. All right, I'm
going to bite.
Wow, it's very like a honey, like very like, if you're used to honey kind of thing, it has a very like similar.
It's not too sweet. Mm-hmm. The first thing that came to mind was like, I could put this on a sandwich easily.
my favorite, I know this might be weird, but like culturally, like for me, it's like I would add like butter with this. You know what I mean?
I'm going to add like cheese. Butter. I'm going to add cheese. Cheese, yeah. Right. I got the brie here. I got the fig. Damn. This is figging awesome.
Pun intended. Now you can eat with cheese too. That's what I love about this. It feels like a picnic. You know when you go to a picnic and you just have like, you go to a picnic, there's a chicken, there's a sandwich, there's coleslaw, there's macaroni and cheese, there's dessert. Start where you want.
It has everything.
You want to start with the dips? Go with the dips. You want to start with the
salad? There's no judgment. You can start with the bottle. Oh, we got this bottle of wine. Not wine. It's actually grape juice from them.
Yeah, I mean,
like basically that when you're, it's funny because you say picnic because it comes with this amazing bottle.
Comes with it. What, so this it's the plan. Same idea. Does all of them come? I don't know.
I'm not sure if all of them come.
Right, but this one.
Really cool.
This one that came with it, right? The sparkling blush grape juice. Really nice. We can even have this, but yeah. I guess like it's while like I open
perfect,
this.
It's like your perfect kind of like, you get the cheese, you got the board, bring your friend, your loved ones, and you go to like a nice place in the city or wherever you want to go and you have a picnic. Like you're saying, I love that. It's like, the best way of doing it.
And because like, honestly, they come in covered, right? She brings it covered, everything. So long story short, you just like take it with you to any, like, you know what's my favorite thing to bring this? I already have it.
Where?
The island.
Mm.
Think about it. You bring this to the island with two or three other people, four people.
If it's your first date,
he or she
would love you forever.
It's a memorable date.
Oh, it'll be a memorable day. Very,
like, look at this. Ah, baby, like, let me open this.
In my opinion, food is a huge portion of my life. Obviously, as you know, do it. Yeah, do it. In my opinion, food's a huge portion of my life. Like, if the food tastes good, it makes like more memorable, like you're saying. And that's exactly. That's important because food is life. Honestly, food is life.
I'd love this ASMR.
Kedem. I think it's kosher too.
It is kosher.
Mm-mm.
Do you know what makes this kosher?
Tell me why.
So, I don't know if you know, but fruits and vegetables usually have a lot of bugs in them. What makes it kosher is they make sure that there's no bugs in the fruit.
Has half the thing so sugary.
I'm gonna sample it.
Put some water in there.
I'm gonna sample
this. He's a fun for the listeners that are driving or not looking at the YouTube. Dave just poured this amazing glass, basically a nice half filled glass.
Beauty.
Of Kedem grape juice.
Mm-hmm.
Looks good.
But yeah, I guess before we're going back into the dips, let's try it. Cheers. Ooh,
reminds me. Reminds me of Friday night dinner.
It reminds you of Friday night dinner. I think the experience, I like it. It's like, it kind of has like a champagne taste to it.
Yeah.
And it has a very, what it's called, has a champagne taste to it, but it's not champagne. It's alcohol free.
You don't have to get drunk.
And it's like, tastes great. It has like it's very sugary, right? But again, like you're not drinking a whole bottle. I mean, you could in the process, but yeah, I guess we should go to the next one.
What do you feel? You want to do tzatziki or you want to do like the medley?
I kind of want to do the tzatziki with meat. Should we do tzatziki with meat? I'm going to break a piece of meat off.
Ooh, it looks really good.
Yeah, let's do that.
It looks really good.
Yes, sir.
It's like build your own, you know, you can make whatever you want, as Dave was saying. It's like build your own kind of like board. Like as much exactly. Within the board, you can make your own variations of the board.
Exactly. Cheers. Oh my God. So this is homemade. This is very, she uses like Greek yogurt, like thick Greek yogurt. And then like she makes it.
That was cream cheese for a second.
No, this is, she added cucumbers. You can see there's cucumbers in it from at least this piece. So she pretty much put cucumbers. I think you put like some pickle juice. No, pickle juice in tzatziki. I can't remember. Like some whatever. Or maybe lime. Maybe that's what I'm thinking.
That was good.
Really, really good. Clear that down.
Life is good, my friend. You know what?
We're living like kings.
And?
The final one.
Should we do the last
one? Yeah, the last. Please? I'm not a huge fan of olives. Really? You know. Yeah. I know you love olives. It has a very olive-y smell to it, as I would like to say. I'm going to take a very small bite. I'm going to try it.
Okay.
Wow. Whoa.
Spicy. Good.
you know what? I don't hate it. Like, I'm like for me personally, I can't eat olives on its own. But I like this because what is this? Like peppers, green? Yeah. What? Oh, it's tomatoes, right? You're saying
it's olives, peppers, tomatoes. There's a relish, and there's a spice in here too. This reminds me. Mm-hmm. Have you ever had like street meat, like a hot dog
meat with this?
Huh. True. If you ever had like street meat, like hot dog, this reminds me of like the sauce you put on the side. Like you build your own hot dog. Mm-hmm. Same idea. Because on the side you have like the olives, the relish, everything. It's good. It's nice.
The thing I think the reason why I like this so much, like I don't hate it, like, and when I usually not an olive fan, right, is because it doesn't taste super olivey. You know what I mean? Because I think with the peppers and tomatoes, bring it down, but it's a good crunch. It's like, in general terms, it's like, you know, really good. The great thing about this is like for holidays like Ramadan or Eid or like even people who are kosher but not fully kosher like myself, like who don't eat kosher pork and stuff like that. Yeah, kosher like. But yeah, this is a great experience because it gives people the opportunity to like, you know, just have it and like going to the holidays, like for me personally, right? Like every single year, I usually meet up with my family during the New Year's Christmas time because it's hard, you know, because Hanukkah is like 8 days long and Christmas and stuff and everything's closed and whatever. So we kind of get together like near New Year's and then we might celebrate New Year's together. And I don't know what's gonna happen this year.
Well, you can meet up with a Graz platter. And you can meet up, double pun.
Yeah, I mean, that's, you could. And like, but the thing is, like, what I'm trying to state is, like, we're going to be, like,
isolated. So you can meet, meet up. Yeah, like, you know what you could do now? Because of FaceTime and Skype and Microsoft, you can just, you send a board here, you send a board here. Hey, Mom, how you doing? You all everyone have the fig gem. Hey, if it's one way of supporting her, but also supporting everyone around you, but also being together with
any other business.
Yeah, you're still going to dish out $500 on, you know,
setting up a meal. Like, what was it? Thanksgiving dinners, people are having, $100. You know, things like that. Like, well, how much is a normal big turkey? Like, easily, whatever. And then you have to, like, cook it for 14 hours or 8 hours. I don't know.
You know how many
I've never cooked one of those big chickens, so I don't know. You know, it's an interesting, like, it's going to be very interesting to see how all the holiday season's going to go for everyone in different religions, different cultures, and how, like, people are going to get together because, like, are people going to be getting together? Because I don't think we're going to be 25, 50. Like, so people that I know in, like, Indian cultures, they go to, like, they'll either, like, rent out a banquet hall and they would all come together, right? Or, like, it's kind of like an adventure kind of, like, holiday. Like, it's like they bring a lot of family. So your family comes, my family comes, somebody else's family, like five different families, and everyone pitches in and it becomes cheaper, of course, right?
I don't want to say this, but I feel like I don't want our new normal of being like isolated to continue for family. Like, I remember the last time I could happily, safely invite someone over without being like, oh, are you tested for positive? Yeah. And so that's why I feel mm-hmm. Like my dad and I talk about like every Friday we meet for dinner. It's like,
right. And that's us. It's that's like awesome. That's
our family, our core, very, yeah. Which is great, but we can't have like, God forbid we have you.
Yeah. You had me, like, you had me, I think in May, right? After when we were locked down.
You were 2 years away.
Yeah. I was at the farthest. I was here and then everyone else.
Yeah. Like, hey Dave, how are you?
Well, so, and I came separate, right? I came in my own car or whatever. Yeah. It was all separated. But yeah, I know it's like, you know, it's very scary times, right? Like you can't plan anything anymore, right? Like, I know with you, your trip was delayed as well, right? Because you weren't able to. Originally, pre this, we were only like yellow, orange, red zone, whatever the thing was. But now we're in lockdown, right?
So I can't go anywhere, really. It's hard to go.
So, like there's still limitations and things. And you might replan it in the future. But
the best way to actually, you know, make everyone around us happy is if you hit that subscribe and like button and, you know, give us some support. And we can make you shine some light on you, share some love by connecting you with local brands and giving us our awesome personalities that are here in front of you.
Yeah, I mean, we're here, we're giving love. Also, if there is any brands that would love to work with us, please reach out to us.
Yeah.
We really appreciate it. Hit us up on either The Edible Top, Foodie on the Loose, or DJ Dave K. Instagram is the best way, I would say. By comment below your...
Or our videographer's username, but we can never
pronounce it.
Sorry.
All we know, his name is Michael.
Michael
007. That's all I know. I think I might like that. Think about it. Michael 007 camera or 007 filming.
With like,
can he do that as illegal? I don't know.
No, why not?
Could be like copyright 007. I mean, don't say 007, just say 007. Sounds really catchy.
007. Like, they could tweak it, you know? Crazy. Yeah.
But yeah, it's, you know, and I kind of like where you gotta bring some sweetness, right, to this, to the holiday season. I think that's the number one thing. Like, let me put it this way. What is the number one sweet thing that you love during the holidays?
Are you putting me on the spot right now? I eat too many things.
What's the number one thing that pops to your mind? Like latkes? Like, what is it called? The donuts.
I like blintzes, man. I like sufganiyot.
So explain what that is so people know what that is.
Sufganiyot is a common Eastern European heritage. It's big in the Jewish population, but a lot of Eastern European families, communities eat it. It's like a puff donut and it has jelly in the middle.
Yeah, so it's like a jelly donut. That's the best way to explain it. It's a little different because it's how it's made and how it's pumped. And then there's like a sugar, what is it called?
It's like a sugar, it's like a frosting. It's not a powder. Frosting. It's a powder.
Sugar powder. You know what's really funny? TikTok educated me on this. Do you know how sugar powder is made?
Tell me.
You just take sugar and put it in a blender and you're done. That's sugar powder.
I believe it, yeah.
I was like, and people were like, you don't have to go out of your way. If you have a blender and you have sugar in your face, that's all, you just blend it. I'm like,
yeah, but how many people know? Sufganiyot are fantastic. You can find it in Toronto. I know from a lot of Jewish bakers. I'm not claiming that the Jewish people, it's their donut, but a lot of people have this donut and you can easily get it at the Jewish bakers.
And I think my number one thing, I know it's during the holiday season that you always will see it on the table. Ferrero Rocher.
Oh yeah, 100%.
You toss 100%. Those, they're like popcorns.
Yeah, or the good, oh man, I got a couple of gifts for friends and family. It's like the Godiva from Costco.
Oh my God.
It's like, honestly, it's so cheap. It's like this massive, like huge. Like
which thing. One is it? Like in a clear container or is it?
It looks bigger than it actually is, but it's like a platform container. It's like a circle. And it's like all the way around.
That's crazy.
Epic. And honestly, for $20, $25, it's 20, whatever,
yeah. It's because it's so ridiculous. Cheap. If you go to Godiva's store, that exact same thing would have been $100 or something. Costco. It's because Costco.
They're making like nothing on it, probably.
No, there's all. I mean, they're making money because they're selling their memberships, right? That's where Costco makes most of their money, right?
It's crazy and concept.
It's crazy. Like, you know what's crazy? Like, you're having like these crazy giveaways going, right? You're having like 12 days of giveaway for the, for the Christmas holiday.
We're in it. Right? We're in the middle of it right now.
So, yeah, it's like nonstop. If you're hearing this, you're on that day. You might be, there's a few days left on the giveaway. You should totally check Foodie on the Loose.
There are, you know,
we might have some like edible talk giveaways. We might have something coming up or it might be going on. Sorry, let me rephrase. It's going on right now. So, you know. Check it out, and there's
who knows. There's so much stuff that's where we're doing, and it's just
giving a free car, right? A Tesla 3. That's what it is, right?
Why did you tell them,
David Dobrik?
Why did you tell them? Why did you tell them? You can't reveal those secrets, trade secrets. I mean,
hey, what is that? Five, like they cost $50,000 each. So who's gonna make Tesla's
gonna money, right?
That's it.
And how about
go ahead.
Whoa, you cut me off. No, I'm just messing. I'm just teasing. I really want to try those sweets we got.
Now. Yeah, so being sweet, being all this,
like I know you're sweet. I know you're sweet, Dave. Like you're a nice guy, but like I like sweet foods.
So I'm gonna. I'm sorry. I'm gonna reach over. Sorry, you can't hear my voice. I'm gonna grab the macaroni.
David is grabbing this tower of beautiful holiday joy spirit macaroons.
Oh my God, it's breaking apart. There's a huge
macaroon. Can I take a photo of this? Like as you're doing it. Wow, it's so beautiful. Dave, smile.
Bye.
Hey. Looks so good.
Oh my God. I don't know. Are we gonna
we break it up. Just break it. Try it. Eat it.
Oh yeah. We want top?
Yeah, I'll take top for now.
You like being on top?
Here.
No, it's good.
Cheers.
Cheers. Oh boy.
Save some for him.
He makes these macaroons, right?
It's like a tower of macaroon.
Mm-hmm.
Delish.
Like she made, oh my God. She made a Christmas tree. Really good. Oh my God. There's like the little chocolate balls inside. Really, really good.
That's sweet.
Mm-hmm. It's sugar, right?
Happy holidays.
More photos? Am I that special? Do you want to take a photo here?
Why not? It's fun.
Let's break it. Grab a piece.
Happy holidays, everyone. Cheers.
Cheers. A gingerbread. Oh, my God.
It's like a shortbread cookie.
Oh, my God. It's so soft. I love how soft it is.
Like, usually they're hard, but I love it when it's soft because it's like, sorry, I'm eating while I'm talking. I'm sorry, everyone in the podcast listening to us.
Only here.
I hope you did. You understand what I said?
It's like a shortbread cookie with like an icing on top. Mm. It's you know what'd be perfect with tea. Mm. Dip it in the tea. Put it on the side. Oh,
a little biscuit.
That's really
Wait, good. I never understand crumpet biscuit. Biscuit. It would be a biscuit, not a crumpet.
Mm.
Would it be a crumpet or a biscuit? What's sweet? No, no, sorry, I'm not well versed in the UK culture, the British culture.
Mm-mm-mm.
But yeah,
I love that. Like, we're just eating different foods right now.
They have
like a cupcake.
There's another like. So there's this. We'll break it again. It's like it has like.
It's like a waffle. What is
there? It's like you see. Ooh, that was nice. That crack.
It's like an almond.
So that's pretzel. Okay. I think that's pretzel. They have like little like Christmas tree candies.
Oh my God.
They have caramel. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
It just, as we were saying, this is such a nice like experience that like you can add this to any meal, right?
this is like your, like I said, you can start off with, you know, the savory, or you can start off with the dessert.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get me wrong. I can start with the dessert tomorrow.
Mm.
Or right now, as we speak.
So good.
And I'm going to drink some kedem. Grape juice, which is going to be so sweet too. It's just a lot of sweetness happening.
I mean, let's put it this way. It's a lot of sugar, but
you don't have to have this every day. Year, right? Do you?
Exactly.
Every single day. Sorry.
It's not, I mean, if you want to buy one every day, go ahead. Oh my God.
On point. I'm so happy right now. There's such good vibes here.
Also, you already had the strawberry, right? I have strawberry, apricot, carrots.
You have. Yeah, there's everything.
You can have carrots with a dip. Like
It's like when she went to the store. The lady that runs this is fantastic, Shahida. She's amazing. She's a great human, great soul. Like, love her products.
Mm-hmm.
I think she puts a lot of effort and thought into the boards.
Of course.
Because you don't, like, I've seen a lot of them online, and sometimes it's just like, bleh. It's like there's space of just nothing. And this is actually,
it's also
creative. It's colorful. It's nice. It's beautiful.
If you are on the YouTube, you get the experience of like seeing it, but it's like in this like little like indented, like what are those tray things called? Like when you bring food, like somebody's like
sick when you're going like in your bed.
That's a sick. Yeah. If you're eating out of your bed, like one of those like cute little like, oh honey, I made you breakfast and eggs here.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's kind of like put in one of those like little like containers, stands, and everything's like put in together, because a lot of them I've seen are just put into those plastic containers and they're like really like, you know, cheaply made. Like when you go to like Metro or any of these like grocery stores, you get those like vegetable cartwheels. What are they called?
They're kind of like a carousel. It's kind of like carousel. a veggie platter, but it's a circle. Yeah.
But it's all plastic and nothing.
It's not meant to be good.
And those are like $15, right? And there's veggie, there's fruits, there's everything.
But the beauty of this is like you think you're done, and then there's another layer.
There's so much more.
There's like one layer, two layer, three layer, four layer.
Just to add, they have. So just to clarify, or I guess you have the list. You can go through that whole list. But there's like nuts, there's cheese, there's meats, there's crackers, there's different, there's tomatoes, there's also, you know what you forgot? Here, let me grab this. A little surprise.
Mmm.
Here, sir.
Mmm.
Chocolate raisins, buddy.
Oh.
And it's all sprinkled, right? It's so sprinkled. As you said, right? There's so much more that you can just keep on going. Like, I know you're looking at it right now. You just couldn't eat the whole thing.
I feel like the viewers on YouTube are going, why is he looking just left?
You're right. Everything's to my left. There's no space on the right. We wanted to put it on the table, but it's huge.
It's as big as his like upper body. Sorry, like it's huge.
I'm picking it up. Oh my God.
Yeah, lower that maybe a little bit.
Oh yeah, sorry.
Yeah. Like this is like a whole thing of
cheese. And there's a whole brie of cheese.
It's like this big.
Bigger.
Really.
Like, and there's
so we got dates, we got fruits, veggies, crackers, cheeses, deli meats, dried fruits. Like these are like general titles. Within it they have like subsections, you know. It's like it's crazy. It's,
I know,
it's
and like
amazing.
But there's so many experiences like this,
baklava,
right?
Like, pastries. Like it's just like it's nonstop. It's like literally like what you want when you think
of cupcakes that we haven't tried. There's more sugar cookies, there's more.
I don't think I can right now. Like my like I feel like
I want more.
I'm
cheese
like,
right now.
Me too.
Yeah. Oh, you don't have? Oh.
Yeah, I got.
You can grab this one if you
want. No, I'm good. Good.
In general terms, I really love this. It's a really great experience. I mean, during the holiday season, like in general terms, like
we've tried so many different foods. You've tried so many different foods. You got those like chocolate strawberries, I remember as well.
I guess the brands I want the most are chocolate strawberries because I just like eating the chocolate strawberries the most.
Like, and the crazy thing is, you know what really crazy is? Everything blends together so well. Like, I just had sweets, and I just had a strawberry, I had a carrot, I had some cheese. Feels like they all blend together. Like, I'm not, you know, usually when you're like, oh, don't mix your like soup with your with your dessert. But it's like, I know there's no soup here, but it kind of just like everything blends so easily together.
She says it's for 2 to 3 people.
No.
This?
No. What?
No.
This is 2 to 3 people?
No. No.
Dude, we're eating right now. We're getting full off this. Our cameraman ate it. That's 3 people. And you just saw, I held it up.
We haven't even dented it. We honestly haven't even dented it that much.
There's at least 2/3 left. So easily 9 people. Like,
six,
again.
Six. Let's call it six.
Again, if you're just sitting, but again, like, you're not sitting this and just like eating it like a meal, right? You're
having a meal afterwards or before. Like, this is like four rice. It's like your appetizer.
Exactly. It's like you're, well, you can get filled.
Like, you're watching the game and you're like chilling, talking with your family. How's everything? How's work? And you're having like, you know, hors d'oeuvres.
It's like hors d'oeuvres.
You know what we forgot about?
What?
The NBA is coming back.
I know.
Oh my God.
There were some trades.
Oh my God. We lost Gasol. Ibaka. We lost Ibaka. Danny Green got switched again. But right now, Danny Green is in a winning streak. So yeah, every single time he switches, so now he's going to the Clippers and he's going with Kawhi.
Isn't that crazy? The Lakers to the Clippers. Like,
the biggest teams, man. The biggest upcoming teams. Because crazy. Clippers is upcoming right now, right? They just got all the big players. They switched everything. Like, we are done. Like, we're getting to the point that it's just like, it's going to be really exciting to see where we're going to just unfold to. Like,
I mean, like, we just had a couple boxing matches recently in recent times.
Not Logan Paul, Jake Paul versus Nate Robinson.
And there is light at the end of the tunnel. There is light, my friend. There is stuff coming out of there, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, people can do things now more on television.
Right, for sure. And, you know, usually at the end of every episode, we usually shout someone out. During this holiday season, we'd like to...
I want to shout out the clothing I'm wearing right now.
Oh, yeah, right.
It's a really cool company. It's one of my also 12 days of giveaways. If you missed it, I'm sorry, but maybe work again with them.
Right.
They're called So Fetch Apparel. It's ironic because I typically don't deal with clothing brands, but... I really love the slogan, Merry Christmas, you filthy animal. It's a very popular slogan. And it's funny because they do dogs, like they have animals, and I just like love animals. And I also love, I think it's a funny slogan, so why not give them a shout out?
Yeah, I mean, that's really cool. Like my shirt right here, I got this years ago from Loot Crate. It's also a package, like every month they send you a new package.
What is Loot Crate?
It's just like a bunch of like, they sent you like limited edition every month. Like this month might have been like retro 95, like retro gaming, you know, like those old like.
Is it a subscription?
It's a subscription base. So they send you a box, they send you a shirt, they send you a comic, they send you a toy figure. Everything's different. You don't know what you're getting. All you know is the genre.
Well, I hope they know your size.
What?
I hope I know your size. Oh, I got a small pink.
So the funny thing is, one of my boxes, I got socks. How big is my foot size?
Nah, it's like 16, 17 inches.
I have 15 feet shoes, and they sent me size 7 socks. I put it on and I sent them a photo. They're like, sorry, here's your money back. They were nice. I was surprised. I was like, I mean, I shouldn't have complained, I guess, because I can just give it away as a gift to someone because whatever. But I was like, you guys should have asked or at least have my foot size that, you know. And yeah, one size fits all. But it wasn't that great.
That was a good episode.
Yeah, I mean, I had fun. I'm just enjoying. This feels like this. You know what this feels like right now? Like, it's just family. Like, you know,
we're a family.
Power station.
What can we do to kind of like wrap it up? What do you think's the best?
I mean, to wrap it up, I think the one thing I want to ask you is what are you thankful for this season? You know, that's our ending here.
You know, I'm thankful to be here with you and Michael. Just to be together, like we're one big family, and we're trying to promote and spread positive vibes and image to people during a really bad time.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's important that we have each other to, you know, rely on and help each other to thrive and grow. 100%. How about you?
Yeah, you know, I'm very thankful for everyone, like people around me, especially, you know, everything that, you know, my job, all that. I'm able to, you know, be where I am. You know, we're all struggling a little. We're all trying to get through day by day. But in general terms, you know, I'm thankful. I'm thankful for everyone. I'm happy that everyone I know who's been sick or whatever has been healed or has recovered. Sorry, I meant to say. So, you know, in general terms, we're in a good light. And, you know, I hope everyone the best. I hope everyone the best holiday season. You know, New Year's coming up. And, you know, we hope the best for everyone and the best healthy Christmas, healthy holidays, healthy, you know, New Year. And just, you know, make sure to, you know, hit that like button, subscribe to our channels, comment, also review us, right? How many stars again?
5 stars if you can. If it's a 4 or 3, we'll talk. Please,
we want to know DM why. Us, see what it is, because we're always trying to create a conversation. The Edible Talk is here. Foodie on the Loose is here. Like, we're building with DJ Dave K. We're just building something, and hopefully the new year will arise, have influencers involved. We'll have new locations. We'll have a lot more, because
giveaways, prizes, stuff. Like, 100%. It's going to be a whole different outlook on our new year, and I think everyone's going to come out like, wow, these guys are no joke, because we are no joke.
We are no joke. We're growing every single day. We are easily growing 10% plus a month, or whatever it is, or per podcast, not even month.
We started at 0, I believe, right?
We started at 0.
Yeah. You know what? Now we have more than one listener. It's a win for me. Small win.
A lot more than one listener.
It's a win for me.
But yeah, we appreciate everyone out there. Thank you again. Have a wonderful day. Happy holidays. Happy Christmas. Kwanzaa. I know all these holidays might not be occurring, and I'm sorry, but happy every holiday. We love you guys. Peace out.
Cheers.
And we will see you later.
Woo. Thank you for watching today's episode of The Edible Talk. We appreciate your support on our journey to try new foods and experiences.
Show some love by hitting that subscribe button and turning on that notification for new episodes released weekly. For behind the scenes and clips, follow us on all social platforms at The Edible Talk. Thank you so much.
Goodbye.